Hello, boys and girls. Welcome back to day 6 of this year's Week of Prayer Readings for Children. I do hope that you've been enjoying our stories about the importance of continuing to witness, no matter how unworthy we may think we are, or how bad our situations get, when we stand for Jesus. He will come through for us, even if we're in the lion's den, like Daniel. Today's story is called Second Chances, and it's taken from the New Testament book of Acts, chapter 9. And it's about witnessing in death and what we learn from the impact of Tabitha's death. The story will be read to us by two sisters, Stuti and Thrupti.
Hello everyone!
The title of today's story is called Second Chances.
The Bible treasure for this story is Acts chapter 9, verses 36 to 43.
There were beautiful quilts laid out in Tabitha's living room. She had a special gift for being generous, and she would sew quilts, clothes, and blankets for people in her town. She was a friend and helper to poor people. Tabitha was also known as Dorcas. She lived in a town called Joppa, which was a busy port by the sea. Many boats came to Joppa with visitors.
Tabitha was known as an apostle or helper of Jesus because of the love she had shown making clothes for those who needed them. "Hey Tabitha, thanks again for that really pretty scarf you made for me," said a visitor standing outside her door.
"No problem, I just want everyone to have what they need," said Tabitha. Everyone loved Tabitha. She welcomed everyone into her home with a warm meal and a gift of something she made. If a family didn't have enough money to buy new clothes, Tabitha made sure to help by making clothes for some of these families. Many people were encouraged and thankful for someone like Tabitha. God gave Tabitha not just a gift of hospitality, but also the gift of sewing. Tabitha loved God and loved people.
One day, Tabitha got very sick. She got worse and worse, and the doctor could not find any medicine to help her get better. After a while, Tabitha died. What a shock it was to those who loved her. Everyone in that town was heartbroken and cried. Her body was washed and prepared for burial.
Meanwhile, some people had heard that Peter was in a nearby town. Some of the people remembered that Jesus' disciples not only healed, but also brought back people to life. They believed that Peter could bring Tabitha back to life. They sent some men to find Peter and ask him to come and help them. "Peter, please come as fast as you can. Tabitha has died," they said. Peter went with the men, and when he got there, he went upstairs to the room where Tabitha was lying. "I need all of you to leave this room, please," Peter said.
He knelt and prayed to God. Then he looked at Tabitha and said, "Get up." Tabitha opened her eyes and got off the bed. As she walked out of the room, everyone looked with amazement and praised God.
"A miracle from God has happened. Tabitha is alive," they said.
The people started telling everyone what Peter had done through the power of God, and many people started to believe in Jesus. God brought Tabitha back to life to show how marvelous he is.
So that's the end of the story, and now it's your turn. There are some thoughts that you can take away.
What good things can you do to help others in your community or church? Maybe you could pick up trash at the park, help the needy by donating money with the help of your parent, or give away clothes that you don't need anymore.
How is helping the poor and needy a good way to witness? Thank you.
Thank you, Stuti and Thrupti, for bringing us yet another powerful story today about the importance of witnessing. And what have we learnt from the story of Tabitha? I think the key lesson from today's reading, where we heard about the good and kind work of Tabitha, a woman of God, is that the death of a witness may be the end of a life, but it is not the end of a witness. Now, what does Auntie Judy mean by this, you may ask? Well, whether the resurrection is soon after death, as in the case of Tabitha, or delayed until the second coming, those of us who remain can continue the work of sharing God's message of truth, hope, and love. Let us carry on the work left behind, the legacies of those who have used their talents and resources to bless the communities around them. And despite how sad we may feel, particularly with the loss of a loved one, let us try hard, boys and girls, to continue to give glory to and worship our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ, who sustains us and sits beside us through our grief, and who will someday wipe away every tear from our eyes. Let us pray. Dear Jesus, we thank you for the story of Tabitha, which explores the miracle of when you used Peter to raise Tabitha back to life. This has taught us as children that we can learn how our own lives can lead others to you, dear Jesus. Dear Jesus, help us to reach out to our friends and others as Peter did with Tabitha. We're also thankful, dear Jesus, for the lesson in this story that encourages us as children to use our talents to serve you and to help others. We know that this is what you want us to do. Sometimes, dear Jesus, we might think we don't have what it takes. We don't have the right skills. We are not smart enough in some cases. But all these stories so far this week, dear Jesus, have reminded us how important it is to trust you to shape our lives and use us and our talents for your great purpose. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Boys and girls, thank you so much for joining us again this week for our special children's readings in this annual week of prayer. I hope that you will be encouraged by not only today's story of witnessing despite the obstacles we face, and join us tomorrow for another story from the Book of Acts, where we will learn about witnessing from a story about tent making for Jesus. It's time to say goodbye from me, Auntie Judy, and look forward to seeing you tomorrow.
Salvation and glory, honor and power unto the Lord our God. For the Lord our God is mighty. Yes, the Lord our God is omnipotent. The Lord our God, He is one. The Lord our God, He is wonderful. Hallelujah, salvation and glory, honor and power unto the Lord our God. For the Lord mighty, yes, the Lord our God. is omnipotent. The Lord our God, He is wonderful.
Oh, praises be to the King of Kings and the Lord our God, He is wonderful.
Salvation and glory, honor and power, He is wonderful. Hallelujah, salvation.